Chetty from Vetri and Vetri Neat Chemistry. Today let us see the important topic of your equivalent weight and the number of gram equivalents. Let us see the knowledge behind the equivalent weight and the number of gram equivalent. Okay, before going to the knowledge, let us see what is the important of your number of gram equivalent. Let us see. Take any acid for your information. Let us take the sulfuric acid. It is the acid. The base, well known, is the sodium hydroxide. Reacts to give the sodium sulfate plus, and then what is it called? The water. Now let us balance the equation to sodium. Okay. So now the reaction is, what is the called as a hydrogen 2+2, 4. 2+2, 4. You put it the 2. Okay. So now the reaction is balanced. Okay, what is this chemical reaction giving information is, based on the mole concept, this is, stoichiometry is given, 1 mole of sulfuric acid reacts with 2 mole of sodium hydroxide gives the product. Okay, regarding the mole concept, what is the important thing is, this is based on mole concept. The equation is written based on mole concept. What is important regarding the mole concept is balancing of the reaction is important. Okay, here it indicates 1 mole with 2 moles. Okay, we are going to use the next method, that is called as a number of gram equivalent. Number of gram equivalent method, where this is going to introduce. In this method, the balancing is, balancing the chemical equation is not required, or we need not balance the equation. Okay, what is this information is going to, if we are talking about number of gram equivalent mean, what is the knowledge is, number of gram equivalent of acid should be equal to equal number of gram equivalents of base, or we can say number of gram equivalents of all the reactants should be the same. So that is the concept based on this. After completion concept, we will verify the knowledge. Now let us, this is the importance of number of gram equivalent method, where the balancing equation, that is stoichiometry, is not required, whereas in the mole concept method, the equation should be balanced for giving the complete knowledge. Okay, now let us see what is the continuity of the knowledge. What is it called? Number of gram equivalent you have to find out mean. Before that, you should know the knowledge of what is called equivalent weight. Okay, now we are going to, the formula is given. Equivalent weight of any compound or any metal, this can be written for any element, any compound, we can write, it is equal to molecular weight divided by n factor. What is this n factor? Can call it as a valency factor. So this is called as a valency factor. Okay, so equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight by valency factor. So now this equivalent weight can be written for acids. For acids, equivalent weight is equal to its molecular weight, any acid, divided by the n factor. In the case it is called as a, if it is acid, mean n factor is nothing but a basicity of the acid. What is the basicity means? I am giving the basicity meaning. The basicity meaning is number of replaceable hydrogen atom in the given acid. That is called as a basicity. Again repeating chana, point number one. If you are talking about acid mean, its equivalent weight is equal to its molecular weight divided by the basicity. Acid mean, use the opposite word, basicity. Okay, next again, what is the meaning of viscosity? Mean number of replaceable hydrogen atom in the acid. For example, let us have the example. If you are taking the sulfuric acid, what is the equivalent weight of sulfuric acid? You have to calculate. Mean molecular weight of sulfuric acid. Molecular weight of sulfuric acid means for hydrogen, one hydrogen is 1.008 into 2. So I am taking as a 2 plus sulfur is 32. Oxygen 16 into 4. On adding, that is the molecular mass of sulfuric acid divided by viscosity. Here replaceable hydrogen is 2, or I can say the n factor is equal to 2. So now divide by 2. Now let us add it here. Yes, 98 divided by 2. So what you are getting is called as a 49. So equivalent weight of sulfuric acid is, this is equivalent weight of sulfuric acid is 49. What is 98? Is the molecular weight of sulfuric acid. So what is the viscosity of the acid? 2 is the viscosity of the acid. Okay, now like this you have to find out. Let us see. If you want to have the one more example, mean you take hydrochloric acid. Hydrogen 1, chlorine is 35.5 divided by replaceable hydrogen is 1. So 36.5. So this is divided by 1. So in the case of hydrochloric acid, your molecular weight is equal to 36.5. Your equivalent weight also is equal to 36.5 because here the n factor replaceable hydrogen is 1. We are going to see some more different example regarding the acid is. Let us see the very beautiful examples. First example I will give, this is called orthophosphoric acid. For this the equivalent weight is equal to molecular mass. What is, let me write, of course I am not going to do here with the number. Let us give the formula. So for this orthophosphoric acid, equivalent weight is equal to molecular mass divided by n factor. What is the n factor? Is here replaceable hydrogen is 3. How we can say replaceable hydrogen is 3? Mean give the structure. Phosphorus valency is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here how many oxygen? 4 oxygen. I am giving the structure of your orthophosphoric acid. Again I am repeating, children. You put the P. That is your formula is H3PO4. At 2P you are putting here. You take oxygen, 4 directions you are putting. Here outer valency for your phosphorus is 5 valency electron. So now you have completed this. Now we have to give the hydrogen only. So that one you are putting here. So now here you are having all the hydrogens are your replaceable. So for this n factor is equal to 3. So here what is the equivalent weight is molecular weight. Molecular weight divided by 3. That's all. If you want to, what is the thing is important point is viscosity of the acid is 3. Now let us go to the one more acid. This is called as a H3PO2. So here what is the equivalent weight is same molecular weight divided by n factor. So to find out the n factor, you have to draw the structure. Already I told how to draw the structure is, again I am for this I am giving, give the phosphorus first. And give the, how many oxygens are the 2 oxygen. You see here this is. Okay, now what is one more minute, children. First let me give. For this you give the base tetrahedral. Afterwards I am giving oxygen. Here 2 oxygen over. Now this oxygen I am putting valency 2. And this oxygen I am putting valency 2 itself by sharing with the hydrogen. Now how many hydrogen? 3 hydrogen. 1 is over, 2 and 3. Now this acid is ready. Now this is the acid. This is called hypophosphorus acid. For your level, how to draw is very important. How we are putting is, again repeating, you put phosphorus at the middle. Then you put tetrahedral, just 4 bond. Completely, then you go for oxygen. Oxygen valency is 2. Hydrogen. Now coming to the replaceable hydrogen is 1. So here n factor is equal to 1. So what is equivalent weight is molecular weight divided by 1. So let us see one more acid is your phosphorus acid. With that, we will conclude that assess all the examples what we are discussing is very important. Especially the past plus assess are very important. Now, let us see the equivalent weight of this asset. Okay, before that, let us go and draw the structure. Phosphorus, as I told, this is tetrahedral. Then you put three oxygen, 1, 2, 3 oxygen. Complete one oxygen with a double bond. Okay, three hydrogen is there. 1 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen. Here I should put hydrogen only. So that structure is ready. Verify it. 1, 2, 3 hydrogen. Phosphorus, 3 oxygen. So structure is ready. Now you see what is the replaceable hydrogen mean? These two only, that is N factor is 2. Or I can say the basicity of the acid is equal to 2. Even though it is having 3, but this one you cannot replace. When the hydrogen attached with the oxygen, when the hydrogen attached with the highly electronegative oxygen is replaceable. Hydrogen with the phosphorus is not replaceable. So this two only considered as a basicity of the acid. So for this, what is the equivalent weight is equal to gives molecular weight divided by 2. So regarding this, I have completed the all the phosphorus acid. So all these questions are very important regarding the entrance as well as the knowledge. Now we are moving to the next one. As it is over, I have to go to the next set of the chemical is the base. There also the same formula. What is the formula? Equal to the base children. For the base, same thing only. What is it? Molecular weight. Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by N factor. Here N factor, it is the base. N factor is acidity. Base means you say opposite word acid. Acidity. Acidity. What is acidity? It is equal to number of replaceable. Replaceable OH group. This is called as a acidity. Let us see the example. Let us see one by one. You take sodium hydroxide. What is the equivalent weight is equal to? Its molecular weight. At the time of calculation you can put it. Now I am focusing on only N factor. How many OH is able to remove is only 1. So here it is molecular weight divided by 1. If you are going for your calcium hydroxide, what is the equivalent weight is equal to? Molecular weight. Molecular weight of calcium hydroxide divided by 2. Because replaceable hydroxide OH is 2. What is OH is acidity. It is the base. So number of replaceable OH is called acidity. What is the acidity of this one? 2. Okay. So what is equivalent weight? Molecular weight divided by 2. Okay. If you are going to the next one. What is this? Is aluminium hydroxide. Where number of replaceable OH is 3. So here the equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by 3. Now let us go to the next one example. We are moving to the salt. So far we have finished with the acid over children, base over children. Next we are moving to the children. Now we are moving to the third category. What is the third category? Salt. Okay, some examples of salt are given. Sodium carbonate, aluminium chloride. Carbonate 2 valency, sodium 1. Aluminium chloride, aluminium 3 valency, AlCl3. Aluminium sulfate, sulfate valency is 2, aluminium is 3. Okay, these are the different salts are available. So before going into the formula, I have written the here cation. It ionizes to give us 2 sodium ion. Each one is positive. So total number of the positive charges 2. Here aluminium, here the total positive charge here is the 3. Here one aluminium have, you can see ionization like this it ionize. So 2 aluminium ion, each aluminium ion is 3 plus. So very important point, here you have to put the valency, here you have to put the number of atom. So 2 aluminium ion, each carries the 3 positive charge. So 3 into 2, so how much positive charge total you are having? The 6. Okay, now let us go to your salt. What is the equivalent mass of your salt is equal to molecular weight divided by N factor. What is the N factor is here? In the case of salt, it is written, see children, total positive charge on the cation. So that is for the salt. Now in the case of sodium, one sodium is having 1. So 2 means 2. So here the formula is, for this the formula is molecular weight. Molecular weight divided by 2. For this is the equivalent weight. Molecular weight divided by 3. Here the equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by 6. You can see children, this is also aluminium, this is also aluminium. Whereas in the case of aluminium, denominator, the positive value is only 3. 1 aluminium ion with 1 3 tile. Whereas in the case of aluminium sulfate, each molecule gives 2 aluminium. So total positive charges are having 6. Even though both are the same element with a different positive charge. So you are giving. With that, we are completing the salt.